Flooding rain has ripped a building from the ground on the Gold Coast, swallowing cars, homes and businesses. Tonight, new video from the peak of the storm when hundreds of millimetres were falling in mere hours.
It came in fast and heavy, pelting rain across a city already saturated, submerging streets, swallowing cars. At Burleigh, parks turning into rapids. The water rushing down the valleys, getting stuck on low-lying roads and inundating homes. Kathleen's place at Currumbin Waters was under construction, now it's underwater, racing back from work just in time to keep her pets dry.
I never thought it would happen to me. I know you hear people say that all the time.
Here in Currumbin, there's been so much rain, the roads are almost completely underwater. People are still driving through floodwaters, sometimes on the wrong side of the road. Police have only just arrived and they're trying to stop people.
Slow them down because they might be in the wake and they're washing water through the yard. It was starting to come through towards the front of the door.
Currumbin Creek Road looking more like Currumbin Creek, disappearing beneath floodwaters. Rising so quickly, businesses didn't have a chance to prepare. A surprise pool party for Sells Auto, putting tools down and cars up. And having a barbecue and beers in their flooded shop.
Get an Uber home, if a boat maybe or something.
A watch and act issued for Currumbin and Talabudra catchments. They were hardest hit. 122 millimetres falling in just 2 hours upstream at Oyster Creek. 177 millimetres between 9 and 2. That's more than what usually falls for the entire month.
In the rivers and the like, I'd say, look, don't swim in there. Bacteria levels high, you will get infection.
At Mudrabar Showgrounds, buildings began floating away. People kayaking in the streets, some swimming across crossings instead of walking. Board riders catching a different kind of wave. Others surfing in creeks. Backyards now joining our beaches in needing a good clean-up. This morning, the very long and very expensive job was only just beginning.
Later on, the scarping, the machineries will come out once the debris's cleaned.
Now, it's got to start all over again. Well, in the last hour or so, the floodwaters here are really starting to recede, at least over the roads. But if you take a look over here, the floodwaters in this paddock are still knee-deep, and that's going to be here for some time. Now, in the space of just a few hours over lunch, SES on the Gold Coast received more than 150 calls for assistance. That number now is likely to be much, much higher, and that's because many people are only now able to return home to assess the damage. So, Melissa, we won't know exactly how bad these floods have been until the cleanup begins tomorrow.
Mackenzie, thanks for that update. We'll go now to weatherman Luke Bradnam, who's at Surfers Paradise tonight. Luke, when could the beaches reopen?
Well, Melissa, it could be as early as tomorrow morning. Council will meet in the morning and make a decision. But if you look down here at the moment, you can see the surf has dropped off considerably from what we saw earlier in the week. And surprisingly, a few people out swimming despite the beach closures. Down here on Surfers Paradise, we haven't really seen too much erosion or debris washing up. But it's a different story down the southern end of the Gold Coast. The cleanup continues and will for the time being as that debris makes its way out of our estuaries and river systems. But do have some good news for you. Severe weather warning that was in place for most of the afternoon for southeast Queensland has just been cancelled. The big question now is when will we see some sunshine again, Melissa? I'll have all those details coming up a little later in the bulletin.
Look forward to it, Luke. Thank you.